Today we are going to discuss about Lecha Dodi Likrat Kala. Just in a few hours in New York, we are welcoming the Shabbat. And welcoming the Shabbat with a beautiful song of Lecha Dodi. And I want very much that you will listen to this in a composition, playing my son Yaakov Boch and singing myself with him together. So listen to the song and then I will speak what you have behind this beautiful song. So what you heard now was my composition, Chadodi Likrat Kala, played my son Yaakov Boch, and singing with him together, Chadodi Likrat Kala. Go my to the Kala, Italian Kala. No, beautiful song, definitely based on the idea that God and the Jewish people like Chatan Bekala. Yeah, it's a famous idea, is one knows, based on the Medrash, which says that Sabbath complained to God, I don't have a couple, Sunday, Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, but I'm lonely. So God said, no, you will have beautiful Kala, yeah, Jewish people. So this is really all the idea of this song. Lecha Dodi Likrat Kala. To beloved Dodi, uncle, but his beloved Dodi, Likrat Kala, come to us. This is the Sabbath, the day, definitely. As we said, the Hebrew word Shabbat is Shin Bat, the Shin, come to the daughter of Israel. So let us now speak about what you have in this wonderful song, not song, a beautiful song, but in the words, what is behind, because it's a very Kabbalistic song, you know, that it was composed a long time ago by the great Kabbalist, Avshalom HaTzadik, HaKabetz. So definitely this song has to do with Kabbalah. In fact, it's based on 10 parts. I mean, you have in this Lechadodi, you got two shul, you count it, you have 10 pars. Bishir li zebi yeshin Shlomo Kabes, Shamor vezachor, Likrat Shabbat, Migdash Melech, Nari, he's written Shlomo Alevi. This is what he was. So with all together, with Lechadodi, you have 10 pars, and this is parallel to the 10 spheres. This is a song of Tshuva, which I composed. Tshuva Alei V'Shuva Lachem, this is based on the prophet's verse. And this is to do with Shabbat, because Shabbat is written in the letter Shabbat, unlike Teshuva. But this is that day to repent. So Shubu Elai v'Shubu Alechem, he said, God said, come back to me and I will come back to you. So going back to the Chadodi, it's amazing how important is learning Hebrew to know and to read Hebrew. Because in Hebrew and translations, it's like black and white. Here, I'll give you an example. The beautiful example is really the song Lecha Dodi, Likrat Kala, Pnei Shabbat Nekabla. Right? Lecha Dodi, beloved, go to Kala, to the bride, Pnei Shabbat, the face of the Sabbath, will welcome. Okay, in English, beautiful, explanation, translation. Okay, but what you have more in Hebrew that you don't have in English? What you don't have? You don't have the message of the number of letters. Well, the letters, when you translate Lecha Dodi Likrat Kala in English, will not have the same number of letters in Hebrew. Yeah. So, what is in Hebrew? In Hebrew, Lecha Dodi Likrat Kala have 26 letters. Yeah, 26 exactly, you can count. Lechadodi, Katkala, Lechadodi, 3, 4, Katkala, count exactly 26 letters. In Lechadodi, Katkala, 26 letters, which definitely indicates to God. Yud Kevavke, Yud A, A5, Vav 6, A. You say in English also, God, Yod also 26. And he says it's only in Hebrew, 26 are two verses. Echad 13 and Ahava 13, because Shema Yisrael Hashem Elokeinu Asher Echad, God is one, 13. Jews are not afraid of 13, you know. In Israel you have also in the, you know, in the lift you have number 13 also in the state is a problem. Okay, so this is, and Echad Shema Yisrael Hashem Echad, so 13, you know, in Hebrew, you have 13 midot, 13 attributes, you have 13 race and Torah. 13 very, very important. So 26 to 13. In English also G-O-D. God is good. So the Chagodi Likrat Kala have 26 letters, which in itself is a message, right? Godliness in this verse. This is also part of our song for Shabbat, Yom Shabbaton and Yishkoach. Don't forget the day of Shabbos. And this is the day of rest. Yeah. Yes, this is a day of rest, the day the Jewish people find rest in it. So give us this day for rest. Now let us see more things in Lecha Dodi. And this is a beautiful build-up of this part, Lecha Dodi Likrat Kala. So if you take this sentence, Lecha Dodi Likrat Kala, you can immediately realize that it is built of 4 and 3. Right? Lecha Dodi Likrat Kala, go my beloved towards Ba'al. May Shabbat, Nikabala, the face of Sabbath, you welcome. Yeah, clearly, Chadodi Likrat Kala, May Shabbat, Nikabala. So there is also a message in the 4 and 3. If you remember, I told you a beautiful idea about God, Gimal Dalet. Remember, if you write God, you write the letter Gimal Dalet. You know the shape of the Gimal, like a man who is going, we said, Dalet is send always next to the door, next to the Dalet. So the Gemara says it's a good person, is a man who goes to help people, you know. So Gimel Dalet, 3 to 4. We said also 3 and 4. 3 represents the giver and 4 the recipient. It is very interesting also that you have the triangle, yeah, like a 3, also the shape of influencing, yeah, giving them. And you have the box, which is a 4, right? 4. This is called Merubaya, like a vessel, it's 4 lines round, recipient. So amazing. So the 3, the triangle is the influencing, and the 4 is the recipient. You have 3, 4 fathers, and 4 mothers. Normally the father gives to the mother. Okay, but this is an amazing idea, definitely. And this is Gimel Dalet, representing really harmony. The 3 give to the 4, the giver, the good person who gives. But if you read this word backwards, you have Dalet Gimel. What is Dalet Gimel? What is Dag? In Hebrew is fish. Why is a fish opposite so? Mirat Yenaim says, amazing idea. It says, because fish is exactly the opposite of God. Why? Because God, Gimel Dalet, means a good person who goes, yeah, to help. Yeah, he goes, he looks for people needed and helps them. So this is exactly the right way of Gimel Dalet. Dag, the fish, represents exactly the opposite. Because the fish all the time, you can see, in the water, the mouth is open, and open all the time. Which is a symbol of somebody like he is thirsty, want to get water all the time to get more and more, yeah? Exactly the opposite of a good. Good, Gimel Dalet, he goes to help the poor, and he likes the poor one, like, looks like the fish is poor all the time to be in the water, and it's, right? So, that, this is what really the situation is. In fact, he says this is one of the reasons to eat fish on Shabbos. We should feel like fish, like some fish is beauty, butter. But also, not an explanation, correlation of righteous people, whatever it is. But the main idea, he says, is that we should feel on Shabbat and Sabbath, which is day of learning. We are not working, yeah, we are not looking around, you know, for shops, we don't go out. Really, you have time to study, to learn, and then we should have more and more really thirst to learn. And Torah is like water, yeah. This is really the idea of eating fish on Shabbos, because a man in Shabbos should learn as much as he can, he should have all the children around, not the children will be out, but all the family speaking about Torah with a portion of the week. How much time of learning want to do more and more? Like the fish in the boat and all the time running around to have more and more into it. This is exactly the idea. Interesting, once I gave a lecture to people, the students and so on, who learned the languages. So I want to show them that Hebrew really has meaning behind every word which you don't have in English. So I told them, tell me people, you can tell me why the opposite of God, G-O-D, is D-O-G, dog. What about a dog? What to do with God? What? I don't know, we said, maybe dog, you didn't know what to say. So I told them, why you don't know? Because you don't know Hebrew. In Hebrew, dog is fish, and the explanation has to be said. In English, the dog is a kelev, dog. Not dog, interesting, the Americans say dog, it is exactly like a fish. The English say more dog. So what is the idea? The idea said because the dog, in the Bible, it's written that dogs are always thirsty, raving. They always are looking for food. Yeah? It's exactly like the fish. So this is like the four and the three. So it says this was the dog. In English, it's the opposite of God, because God is good. He's going to help the poor.
The
dog is opposite. He looks for givers. Amazing idea. Beyond this, letter. But all is four and three. So this was the Chazodi, sacked with four and goes to the three, because we are like dog. We are four, we are poor, we are looking for a giver, for God to teach us more and more. This is really a song which I composed, also playing, singing by my son, myself. And this is the Seudah Shlishit, the third meal of Shabbos against Jacob. And a beautiful song, and this is a psalm that we say three times, Mizmor David, Hashem Ro'i Lo Yachsar. Mizmor David, God is my shepherd, I will not lack anything. Certain event that South Africa that had to compose songs for the cantor Erstig, and so I have to wait for inspiration for songs. As I remember, really, like in the middle of the night, this idea came to me, this song, beautiful, came out. So, beautiful song, it said, Mizmor David, Hashem Ro'i, Lo Yachsar. Now let us carry on with the Chazodi. You see the same message of Jews, like looking for a giver, for God, to get more inspiration. So the first one we said, the Chazodi Likat Kala, Meshabbat Nekabela. Now then we said, Shamor V'Zachor B'Dibrocha, God keep in one world, we know, in one speech, we know God said the term, the, all the commandments, the ten in one breath. Dibur echad, ishmiyanu kelam yuchad. God brought it to us, to hear us, to hear it. Yeah. Also, the same build up, shamor v'zachor b'dibur echad, four, ishmiyanu elam yuchad. Four and three, exactly the same idea. Then carry on, and what is afterwards? Again, you said Echadadi, Katkala, Neshabbat, Nekabela. Then the other part is Likrat Shabbat, Lechuv Mencha, towards the Shabbos go. Four words, Lechuv Mencha, let us go. Go and let us go. Likrat Shabbat, Ki im Mekor Abocha. In fact, Ki is like one expression, because as it is, Ki Mekor Abocha is a source of blessing. Also, four and three, right? Then we say Lechadadi, Likrat Kalam, Meshabbat Mekabla, again. Then comes, after Likrat Shabbat, comes Migdash Melech, Ir Melucha, Kumisi Mirosh. This is afterwards. But amazing that in the really Likrat, as we said before, Likrat Kalam, לקראת שבת נלכו בנלכה, כי היא מקור הברכה. The other part is מראש מקדם נסוחה, from the beginning, מקדם, another expression, מקדם נסוחה, it is like inspired, or סוף מעשה במחשבה תחילה, זה end of deed, of creation, מחשבה תחילה, or the thought in the beginning. What happens here? You have three and four. So after so many, not many, in fact six, if I think, Chadadi Krat Kalav Meshavat Kalavla, and again Shamo V'Zachor V'Chadish Nechad. And then, it means after six, we can Mirosh Mekadem Lesucha, three and four. But there is also teaching in it also. After we have really such longing to learn, to study, to come near to God, to get from Him, then Mirosh Mezen, God give us, then come. There's three and four, comes God. After we feel like dog, like fish in ourselves, to learn to get near to God, and so to attach to God, cling to God, whatever it is, so many times, six times. Then God says, no, Mirosh, Mikredem, Nesucha. Three and four, amazing. How much teaching you have in the order of verse? As we said, all this song is based on Kabbalah, 10 spheres. Now, something also unbelievable is the amount of words in Lechadadi. You see, there are 10 parts against the 10 spheres. And you have 144 words. Why 144 words? Because there are 144 letters in the Vayechul HaShemayim V'aretz. So, those who say, Kiddush on Shabbat, Vechul HaShemayim V'aretz, Chol Tzvaham, these verses, there are 35 words, but there are 44 letters. 144 is those numerical value of Kedem, Rosh Mikedem Esuchah Kedem, the beginning of the word, Kedem. There's a good rhyme also Kedem, they say it, but this is Kedem. And this is a number of words in Lechadodi, words, which divided also 72 and 72. 72 also a very important number, Chesed, full name of God. So, amazing teaching in the numbers of verse, in the Lechadodi, which is exactly like the letters in the verses of creation of the world, V'chul HaShemayim V'aretz, V'chol Tzvaham, the end of creation, heaven and earth. Yeah. This is a song also from my traditions, read by my son Yaakov Boruch and singing together. And this is a song called Ribon Olam, Ya Ribon Olam Ve'ol Maya. God is the creator of this world, which was created with the letter Hey and Yud, the verb to come. Yud, small one, against the verb to come, and the righteous people will be there. And five, hey, this is this word, the hey, which was created with hey. And this is what we praise God on Shabbat, Karibon Olam. God is the master of this world, and the world to come. Now this is a song really for the end of Shabbat, and this we said, Jacob, don't be afraid, the Jewish people, don't be afraid, God is with you, and will save you, as He promised you, and then definitely Elijah will come. This is a false meal, this is the end of Shabbat, definitely the time of Elijah, you know, this is really the night of Shabbat, which is a night that we are expecting and waiting for the redemption, for Elijah to come. So this is a song Al Tira Yaakov, which I composed also, sing my son. But as we said, mainly telling Jacob, don't be afraid, because I swore to you, and so on, all of your promises to Jacob that nothing will happen to him, and God will save him and bring Messiah. So, don't be afraid, Jacob. Hashem Yaakov, God swore to Jacob that He swore that will keep the Jewish people all over all the time. God will forgive the sins of Jacob. Don't be afraid, Jacob. Please bring us back repentant, Yaakov. God redeemed Jacob, all history will redeem us in the future, don't be afraid. Be happy, enjoy, don't be afraid, my Jacob. God will return those by those from exile back to Israel. Don't be afraid, my servant Jacob. When the voice is the voice of Jacob, the voice of Torah, then Al Tirav Yaakov, don't be afraid, my servant Yaakov. Shabbos, and really we need this promise not to go through the week. So many problems, so many difficulties, and this is what God says. Don't worry, Atirav Yaakov, don't be afraid. If you keep the Torah, I will be with you, and we'll be happy, and things will be alright. But if we not, right, you have to be afraid. So, we are nearing Shabbos here in the state, New York. And that's what I wanted to show you today again, the greatness of the Lashon HaKodesh, to show you really how much is behind letters, behind verse, you know, sometimes we don't even know the languages. And this is really what the world will realize in the time of the Messiah, we said in Sephania. Verse 9 says, then I will turn on the nation, clear language, the holy tongue. Means the world will realize how much is the Hebrew language, the Hebrew letters you see. And this is what I tried to show you. Now this is what you hear is now a verse which are composed without song, without verse. Because some say that verse like a little bit cut, you know, the connection, but when it is only music is flowing and the soul comes up better. Composition played by my son, Yaakov Baruch. So, I think, as I said, we are nearing approaching Shabbos. Here we go to Shul. And welcoming the Shabbos, the Chadadi Likrat Kala, the Shabbat. Now, you will understand a little bit more. What is behind this song? Maybe you appreciate it more, you sing it properly. Right? Again, another lecture which I gave you. And Mirza Shem hoping to give you more lectures, all of them to show what is really the Holy Tongue, what is the Lashon HaKodesh, and how much is behind every letter. Gematria, we saw already in other lectures what is the letters, Aleph, and so on. And this is very important, because by this we know to preach the Torah, to preach God, you know, the word was created with the Aleph Bet. And as we said, really part of revelation of Messiah will be the revelation of the Holy Tongue. And really part of it is also the Torah, because the Bible called. In fact, maybe I give you something that you don't need the calculator to make, to see the beauty of the code. So now, I hope that you say Kiddush tonight, as we say Kiddush on the Vine. So the Sat Yom HaShishi, Vaychulu HaShamayim V'Aretz V'Chol Tzva'am. The verse we said, Vaychulu HaShamayim V'Aretz Yom HaShishi on the Friday, sixth day, Vaychulu HaShamayim V'Aretz V'Chol Tzva'am. The earth and heaven finished, so on. Now if you take the letter Yud, Yom HaShishi, Yud, Yom HaShishi, the letter last Yud, you take it every seven letters, you can, Shamayim, you come to Israel, Shin, seven letters after Resh, then Aleph, Elohim, and Lamed. So you have the word Israel, every seventh letter. So the last Yud of Yom HaShishi, not the first one, so Yom HaShishi, Yud, Vayechulu HaShin, Rad Shamayim, Be'aretz and Resh, Otzvam, and you have the word Israel, come Israel, Israel, Yishar Kels, that means God, sing to God, right? In Genesis, amazing, why seven? Because Shabbos is the seventh day. Why comes Israel with the Shabbos together? As we mentioned before, the Chadadi. Why? Because Israel and the Shabbos, like bride and bridegroom. Yeah? So this is exactly the place where it appears. Amazing, at code number seven, and also the right place, which is also important in codes, you know, that the codes are found in the right place. And this is very, very important. So, as we said, we are nearing the Shabbos, opposing the Shabbos, and let us hope that really we enjoy it properly, and we'll get as much as we can from this very wonderful, very important day, the day of Shabbos.